Hello, my name is Rickard, and in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create this composite in Photoshop. If you'd like to follow along, go ahead and download all the assets. They're in a link in the description of this video, and then let's dive into Photoshop. Okay, so I'm going to go to File, Open. I'm going to open this first Jacob Dyer file. First thing I want to do is I just want to make the top a little bit darker. So I'm going to add a new layer. Go G to go onto my gradient tool. And right now it's on basic foreground to transparent. That's what I want it on. So I want it to be linear. And then I'm going to hold down option, select this blue color from the mountain back here, go to the top, go to about where her head is, and just add that like so. I'm gonna put this on multiply, make it just a tiny bit darker there, and then also just have it coming up from the bottom here. So something like this. Next, I want to add kind of a cool glowing box here. So I'm gonna make a new layer. We can call this box. And I'm just gonna go from, kind of want it cutting through her. So something like this. Maybe a little shorter, something like that. All right, and then I'm going to go edit, stroke, and we're going to make this white inside 20 pixels, hit OK. And good. Let's deselect, which is Command D. Now I want to make this glow. Now, if I put a glow on it, which I could do here, it's simply not going to give me the amount of glow that I want, even at, like, you know, full strength. It's just not very strong there. So let's cancel out of this. The way I'm going to do it is with a series of Gaussian blurs. So let's go ahead and copy this, and we can call this glow. I'm going to go ahead and go to blur, Gaussian blur, and I like to start with the highest amount. So for the highest amount, I'm gonna go 200, and then I'm just gonna start cutting in half from there. So next one, I'm gonna make a copy. So we can assume this one's 200. I don't know that I wanna name each one just because it's gonna take too long, but just realize that with each one, we're cutting it in half. So that one's 100, next one will be 50. And this will kind of create this exponentially diffusing light, and it just is a very nice effect. I think it's much nicer than all the layered glow styles. You get a more realistic glowing effect. For this, maybe we'll split it at, let's see, 25, so maybe 12. And then 6. And finally, 3. Okay, and then this is 6, 3, and not. So for the 6, 3, and not, I'm going to take all these. Actually, I'm going to have one copy that remains the same. So these two we'll call small glow. And this is 3 pixels and 6 pixels. And this we'll call big glow. And the big glow, we're going to change the color of. So I'm going to go to Image, Adjustments, Hue Saturation, and we're going to colorize this, pump up the saturation to 100, and then take the lightness down to about minus 30. And then we're going to adjust this to kind of a golden color, something like this. And then we're going to put this on screen. And if we want more color, I can make a copy of that layer. Actually, make two copies if we want something nice, really bright there. So something like this. I'm gonna put all these layers in a folder called Glow. And then I wanna cut her out of this background. So I'm just gonna go here, go to my quick selection or any of my selection tools, select subject, and I want this to be part of the subject. So like so, hit okay. And then we can hold down option and add a mask. That's going to put that mask there. All right, next I want to add a cloud. I'm going to add a new layer. Go to my brushes And I'm going to use one of my Nucly cloud brushes for this, which I'll include in the assets for the tutorial. So scroll down here. And I want one of these freestanding ones. I think maybe this one. All right. And then with that layer selected and white as my foreground color, just going to click twice, like so. Actually, just once is enough. And I want it to not be coming through on one side and then coming through on the other. So I'm just going to select this. I'm going to hold down shift, select it again, because I know it has some transparency. And then in here, I'm going to hold down command and delete. And that's going to just make it black on the mask. I think that looks pretty good. There is a little oddity there where you kind of see the edge. So I think I can just go onto the mask and with a soft brush, just paint out there where the cloud matches or meets, I should say. And I want it not showing through on this side, but I do want it, I want the glow to be in the front here. So I'm just going to paint the glow out of this cloud like so with my mask. There you go. That looks pretty good. All right. And then finally, I want a little moon here. It's another image in our assets here from Jacob as well. Just going to put that in here, put it on screen, transform, kind of change it so that it's under this cloud, something like this. All right, and then finally, we do need a little bit of this glow on the ground. So I'm just going to take the big glow and the small glow here. I'm going to make a copy of them. And just put this right about where our feet are and then flip vertical. And then for these two copies, I'm gonna merge them together, put them on screen, and then just do a bit of a motion blur left to right. Make this look a little more realistic. And then probably make it a little bit darker with a curve. And I can just pull down the middle of the curve. That's going to make it darker overall, but then also go to blue. Just pull down the top. That'll make the whites a little bit yellow. So just like that. Because this mask is already on there, she's being cut out, which is great. And I can put a second mask just on that layer to kind of fade it up from the bottom. And I'm just using a linear black gradient on the mask to kind of run that up like so. All right, pretty happy with that. I do think this needs a little more contrast, so maybe I'll add just a little more darkness to my sky back here. Put this on multiply. Something like that. I think we can also get rid of one of the big glows. And then finally, we're seeing a lot of this banding here. To get rid of that, I can try two things. One is make my image 16-bit. That should help a little. And then I can also add some film grain. Now, there's many ways I could add film grain. I'm gonna actually show you how to do it with a pattern. And that's, I've got a pattern that is film grain. One of these, this one, there you go. Okay, so this is a film grain pattern. And the nice thing about this is I can scale it and it'll stay relatively untiled, I guess you could say. And let's put this on overlay. You can also put it on soft light if overlay is too strong. And then just take down the fill to like maybe 40%. You want it enough to get rid of those banding lines, which that does for the most part. So I think something like that
looks pretty darn good. And there you go. That's how you create that composite. Now, the one other thing I want to show you is all these steps that we took to create this glowing effect. I actually have a action that does all that for me. So let's go ahead here and maybe make a different shape. Let's do a diamond shape. I'm going to transform the selection here. Let me do something like this. Maybe transform it again, kind of make it more like this. All right, and then we'll go edit. We need to make a layer first. Edit, stroke, make this white. And call this glow. And then if I run my action on it, which is called lightsaber glow, I'll have the option to change the color of it here. Maybe there. And now I have my glow set. I can transfer this mask to it. Put this in there as well. And there you can see by having this action, doing all those steps took a hell of a lot faster. And this is included with the Nucly actions, which I'll include a purchase link to in the description of this video. So there you have it. That's how you create that composite in Photoshop. And hopefully through the course of this, you've learned some tips, tricks, and techniques that you can use in your own artwork or projects. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to my channel, leave a like, leave a comment, share this video, and here's some other tutorials to check out. I'll see you next time.